de tus primeros 13 años antes de ir a Inglaterra?
Antes de ir a Inglaterra.
Sí.
What do you remember your 13 years before you went to England?
Can I remember?
Well, what nice memories.
I'd prefer to forget it, to be honest.
Preferí olvidarlo.
¿No fue una época feliz para él?
Wasn't a happy time.
No, it was alright. It's just that it. I forget. I mean, 3 years ago we came to Barcelona, and I've forgotten that. I forget my past very quickly. All I do is think of the future, to be honest.
Hace 3 años vinieron a Barcelona y esto casi lo han olvidado también. Prefiero olvidar el pasado rápidamente para poder pensar en el futuro.
Una última pregunta sobre el pasado. ¿De dónde sacó el apellido de Mercury?
Just one last question about the past. Where did you pick up the name Mercury?
Oh my God. I just made it up. I just made it up. It was just one of the. It's my sort of ruling planet as well from my.
You're Gemini.
My sign. No, I'm Virgo. Virgo is ruling planet.
Es un uno que se inventó porque es la planeta que arregla su signo, que es Virgo.
Ahora, volviendo ahora, en esos 4 años últimos han parado muy poco.
Tell them next year I'm going to be Venus.
El año que viene será Venus.
Freddy Venus.
Uh-huh.
¿En qué medida han influido de estos últimos años de no parar en su obra a nivel de creación? Porque sus temas para mí no reflejan mucho un trabajo de esto agotador.
So, in the last 4 years the band's been working too hard, as it were, solidly, and yet in the new songs it doesn't really reflect, you know, the creativity doesn't look as if you've been completely knackered out, as it were.
Yeah. Oh, you mean that way?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I thought you meant musically we haven't progressed or something. Well, no, there's a little bit of the old horse left. I don't know, what can I say? It's just, I think we've got a lot of energy left. Me, I mean, myself, I think I've got still a few years left in me. And
I don't know.
It's just the way it is. I think we still feel as a quartet we've got so much to give. Because otherwise, if we didn't feel it, I mean, we're very open with ourselves. We'd disband and things, you know. But we still feel we've got a lot to give. So I mean, you'll have a few more albums from us.
Y aún sienten que están llenos de energía, porque si no fuera así, ya habían desmontado el grupo. Él personalmente piensa que tiene como mínimo unos años más. Que puede ir dando marcha y de que si empieza a perder la creatividad, entonces se desbandaban, pero de momento tienen rato para seguir.
Por ejemplo, canciones como Mustafa.
Mustafa.
¿De dónde salen?
Songs like Mustafa, where they come from?
My insane mind.
Su mente insana.
No, it's just. I just wanted to do something. Arabic content, really, because I mean there's so many Arabs in London. I just thought it's a commercial ploy, really. I just thought that the moment they heard that, all the Arabs would rush out and buy it because they're buying out everything else in England. And it's basically a load of gibberish because I just made it all up. I got a few choice words, mm-hmm. keywords which I built round. The rest of it is just gibberish, which I thought was much better because instead of getting it really authentic, I thought I'd just come up with all these guttural noises. And I think it's worked much better than me trying to be authentic.
Que quería hacer algo árabe.
Tell them about the Arabs buying up in
Porque en Londres está lleno de árabes. Y quería hacer algo para vender a los árabes. Como si están comprando todo Inglaterra, pensé, bueno, ¿por qué no pueden comprar un LP de nuestro?
Y toda España.
Así que y España
también. It didn't work.
Así que él dijo 3 o 4 palabras claves, inventó el verso de la letra y se lo montó totalmente a lo comercial, a ver si vendía. No ha funcionado de momento, pero
la idea de la.
A lot of people ask me what the words mean. I don't know the fuck what they mean.
Y mucha gente le pregunta qué significa la letra y no tiene ni puta idea.
But it sounds good, you see, so they want to be. they think it's real. And in America, the stations wouldn't play it because they thought it had a political message, you see. So it worked in reverse in America because the station just wouldn't play it because they thought, I mean, you know what they're like. There's political content, hidden message in it. So they just didn't want to get caught up in it. So they wouldn't play it.
En Estados Unidos, todos los varios pensó que tenía un contenido político, así que no lo ha tocado ninguna. Pero por aquí va funcionando, allá en absoluto, no sé.
Todas las ideas del show en cuanto a luces y en cuanto mismo a su vestuario, ¿son del grupo, son de él o hay un equipo que se preocupa de toda la puesta en escena?
All the equipment that you bring, lights and sound equipment, is it all the band's equipment or do you work with an agency or you hire it all out?
Well, it depends. The lights are all our own. Nobody else has dared to have lights like those. But I mean the PA is obviously a hired thing, because I mean all the top groups do that. Obviously you just hire a PA when you're working and then it goes on. So I mean the beautiful PA companies going in America, you know, they just thrive on that, so they just have, and you just pick them.
De que las luces y el equipo de luces es suyo, porque al fin y al cabo quien más va a necesitar un equipo de luces así. Pero el equipo de amplificación está todo alquilado, que hay unas compañías en Estados Unidos muy buenos para esto, y después de todo, todas las bandas grandes lo alquilan, no, así sale más económico.
Yo me refiero
a cuando no trabajan.
A la idea del conjunto del show.
A sí. the idea.
La coreografía, podríamos decir.
Oh, the idea.
Did
you get that?
Oh, yeah.
Sí, es todo suyo.
Everything is from us. The stage, the whole stage setting, the lights and all that has to come from us.
Yeah. Todo el escenario, las luces, el coreografía, todo viene.
Y el vestuario también, o sea.
The dressing room, the outfits too.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Because it all coordinates, you know, I mean, it's all part of the thing. We've got to tell the people who are building the stage sets and what we want according to what we're going to do musically, so they wouldn't know.
The clothes and the outfits too.
Oh yeah, well meaning these days the outfits are all individual. I mean, we just go and buy or have dresses, make whatever we want. Before we used to have big designers like Xander Rhodes and people like that. But now it's just, I mean, I just wear basic leather and we've grown out of all that over dramatic theatrical stage, I think. We just wear.
Si antes trabajaban con diseñadores famosos como Andrew Bowles, pero últimamente o piden a alguien que les fabrica un vestuario, o más que nada van a tiendas especializadas en esto y buscan equipos distintos para llevar una presencia distinta al escenario. Pero han perdido mucho, piensan, de lo teatro que llevaban antes, en plan de pensar un vestuario para ir con un número.
Su vestuario en concreto, el de él mismo, da unos indicios al público a pensar, ¿no? Pues que lleva una vestimenta un poco facha, ¿no? Un poco nazi. ¿Tiene esto algo que ver con su manera de ser o no sé? ¿Tiene algún significado?
Your particular clothes that you come out in must be leather now. It gives some kind of a Nazi.
Oh, I love it, I love it. Love it.
Does it go down with all your personal beliefs?
No. I have no political. This is just. It's just to enhance the aggression in some of the music we have. That's why, I mean, when we first come on, it's very aggressive, and I like to feel. It's just the way I feel now. Before, I used to wear ballet things. No, it was total contrast, total extreme, the opposite. Just the way we feel when we first come on is so energetic. I felt that the clothes really lend themselves to it. But then I discard those shades and things.
Y que si da esta impresión es perfecto, porque es lo que quieren dar, un sentido de agresión. Pero personalmente no sigue ningún partido político, porque al fin y al cabo todos van a hacer lo mismo.
Y tell them I'm not Patti Smith.
No va de Patti Smith.
It's all a form of entertainment. It's all to do with just entertainment.
Todo es diversión.
Si se puede observar dos claras tendencias en el grupo, que es la tendencia hard rock, música muy fuerte, y la tendencia más bien suave, ¿no? Es piano y voces y tal. Entonces, ¿hay alguna diferencia a nivel de composición? Por ejemplo, que Mai se incline más por el hard rock, por la música más fuerte, y que Mercury se incline más por los temas más de voces, más suaves de piano y tal, ¿hay algo de esto? ¿O simplemente van en conjunto y componen pues lo que salen?
So there's two tendencies that really come out over this on stage. And there's the tendency for hard rock and soft rock, piano and voices. Yeah. Do the different members of the band particularly stand out on one side or the other? Like, does Brian get more into the hard rock side, you get more into the soft rock? Or?
No, I think that kind of
in the composition
across the border, yeah, is throughout the band. Brian is similar in that way, but I mean he writes very different songs. It's a very good question. He has his soft and hard moods as well, but they're totally different from mine, if that makes any sense. Totally different. In my hard sense, it's very different to his, but he has a border as well. He doesn't just like one thing. Roger's more in sort of more fun songs. It's very hard to describe actually songs. John, I would say, is very rhythmic and very sort of commercial, simple songs. Yeah.
El John, más que nada, es muy rítmico. Y le gustan las canciones sencillos y comerciales.
Catchy songs. No, so catchy.
Los que tienen un estribillo que no se puede olvidar, uno de ellos. El Boya,
very fun loving, you know.
Le gustan más que nada las canciones cómicas, divertidas, que tengan un aire de cachondeo, mucho humo. Brian es más o menos como Freddy en el sentido de que tiene una distinción entre el hard rock y el soft rock.
Very different.
Pero es muy distinto su idea al de Freddy, así cuando los dos componen diferentes canciones siempre
his
se nota
idea of being hard is totally
cuál sale de qué lado. O sea, su idea de hard rock no tiene nada que ver con lo que Freddy diría que es hard rock, uh-huh, y viceversa.
Me voy a hacer una pregunta que evidentemente es tópica, ¿no? Pero que se le hace también a los demás componentes y me gustaría saber qué piensa de la reacción del público en Barcelona respecto a su actuación del 74 con la de ayer por la noche, ¿no?
La diferencia.
Sí, o la diferencia o en sí qué piensa de las dos reacciones o si fue la misma.
You've bound to be asked this at least a couple of times tonight,
okay,
this afternoon. But what reactions have you personally felt of the people that saw the show last night and what you can remember from the people that saw the show when you were over here before?
Oh my God, I was trying to say that myself. I can't remember. Oh, Jesus, I've never done it like this. I don't know. Maybe because it was our first time here 4 years ago, maybe there was a bit more of an occasion. Mm-hmm. But I don't know, tonight will prove might be something different. I just it's very hard to say. I felt they were a bit restrained last night. Yeah. And I just felt maybe they were in awe of what was happening, maybe they expected something more because they were reading all New Orleans stories. But I don't know, I thought they could be, it's very different, maybe we're spoiled.
Looser.
Yeah, they could have been looser, but maybe we're spoiled as well, because I mean, we've had German and French audiences going absolutely berserk, and it's very difficult.
Es muy difícil contestar por muchas razones aquí, igual porque la gente ha leído mucho de lo de Nueva Orleans y cosas y estos, pero se sentía un poco detenido por el ambiente de allá. Esta noche espera que le prueben distinto. Pero la primera actuación que hizo aquí, se acuerda que la gente se volvía loco, más o menos como algunos públicos que han tenido en el extranjero en este gira. Igual la gente esperaba otro cosa. Un toque de distinción de anoche.
No sé, la opinión general responde a que ayer no funcionó bien por culpa quizá del sonido, de la mala mezcla del sonido en principio del concierto, ¿no? ¿No cree él que en un show tan majestuoso, podríamos decir, o tan grande, como ellos montan esto, no se puede casi como aceptar?
The majority of people think that the audience didn't get really into it because of some slight problems with the mixing at the beginning, the sound mix.
At the beginning?
Uh-huh, at the beginning of the concert.
Don't know, it's very funny, we had our sound man coming after us, and he said that the first half of the show was going all right, and suddenly there were some technical problems on stage with us, halfway through the show, and that's when it went wrong. And I could feel that as well. So I mean, you hear different reports.
Que todo el mundo lo ve de otra manera. Tú dices que era la primera parte del show que no funcionó, mientras estaban hablando con los ingenieros de sonido que dijeron que el primer trozo iba de coña, pero después por unos problemas técnicos en el escenario, era la segunda parte que no sonó bien. Que todo el mundo lo ha visto de diferente manera.
Oh, but I had a good time.
Pero lo paso de coña, eso sí.
Una cosa, cuando un grupo llega a la altura de ellos y ya consigue el EPs, y ya he leído por algún lado los típicos problemas de que si iban a grabar por separado, de que si iban a descansar, de que si había roces. Ahora que está él aquí, ¿puede aclarar si van a grabar solos, si hay roces y si hay algún problema?
You've got to the point in your career of 7 albums that is a lot of work gone together. The many bands, when they get to this point in their career, there's...
Split up.
Not exactly split up, but there's friction, or the people want to make their own album as well.
Recall
separately, going to the studio, not together. Do you have any problems at all in the band with that?
No, it's just one of those things that we feel that we've still got a lot to offer as a quartet, and I don't know, I think we went about like 2 or 3 years ago, we went through all the ego problems and things, where if we were going to split up, we would have split up then, because we were very full of ourselves. But I think that passed over, and I just feel that we still feel that the best thing we can offer at the moment is collectively. And when there comes a time, we're not going to be afraid to show it, you know, that we want to go solo. Because, I mean, we're old enough, and, you know, we're not scared of things. But at the moment, we want to stick together, because I think that's where the best music is.
De momento aún piensan que tienen mucho que ofrecer como un cuarteto. Hace 3 o 4 años hubo un poco de fricción por rollos de ego dentro de la banda. Y si iban a... desforma el grupo y todo el mundo iba por su lado a grabar LPs, había pasado entonces. Así que una vez más se sienten más unidos que nunca, bueno, desde la primera época, y sienten que van a durar bastante tiempo más como cuarteto, como mínimo.
Because in a funny way, what a lot of people don't realize is that they are sort of mini solo projects anyway, our albums, because like we, the four of us write individually, right? And Each the person who writes the songs, it's like he's got to take it right to the end. So I mean, it's like a solo project. Like my songs are like I write them, and I expect the group to do what I want to do on the songs, and vice versa. Like Brian writes a song, so it's like a mini solo project in their own, and we just put them all on the same album.
Todos los LPs de la banda, o al menos el último LP en particular, son proyectos en solitario de todos los modos, porque cada miembro que escribe una canción le gusta llevarlo hasta el final de la canción y quiere que toda la banda hace lo que quiere hacer, tanto él como cuando escribe Brian, como cuando escribe cualquiera.
No hay mucho, digamos, escuadramiento, o sea, que es muy rígido siempre el planteamiento de que ha de haber 3 temas de Brian, 3 de Freddy, 2 de Roger y 2 de John. O sea, no es siempre muy, o sea, que parece ya como forzado a que tenga que haber ese número
muy
de temas.
Muy consensuado, vamos.
Exacto.
Do you think it seems, they said possibly, no, do you think it's rigid that on the albums there's 3 of your songs, 3 Brian's?
Or 4,
And 4 the other? 2 Roger and 2...
Is it what, rigid?
Ajá.
How do you mean rigid?
¿Cómo quieren decir rígido? ¿Que en cada álbum salía así?
O sea, que antes de hacer el long play ya saben que ha de haber un número determinado de temas de cada señor. 2 de John, 2 de Roger, 4 de él, 3, lo que sea.
Because is it rigid before the album starts being recorded? You say, right, I got 4.
No, I guess what I mean. No. Basically Brian and I are the principal writers, so it more or less goes that we'll have more songs than the other two. I mean, on this album I had 5, I think, and Brian had 4. It really depends. I mean, there's a big fight, you know. We have numerous rounds as to what... Because what happens is we all write individually, and we all come and say, this is what I've got, this is what I've got. And then we fight, saying... Obviously we fight, saying my song is better than yours and this kind of thing. But it's healthy, you know, really. And sometimes it goes on for days. It's very emotional, right? Because we all want our songs on. But, from the very start, I think Brian and I have been the principal writers. So, I mean, the other two will know that we have a bit more say anyway, you know.
Básicamente, Freddy y Brian son los dos compositores de la banda, de todos modos, así que normalmente sale que van a poner más canciones en el LP, de todos modos. Pero cuando llega al principio de empezar a planear un nuevo LP, hay peleas. Pero peleas saludables, que si no hay peleas, no llegan a ningún punto. Y igual están peleando 3 o 4 días diciendo, mi canción es mejor que el tuyo, el otro diciendo que el mío es mejor que el tuyo, pero es saludable.
It gets to the point where whoever in the end is the strongest wins.
Llega al punto que el que es más fuerte gana.
De todas formas, siempre salen dos singles, un tema con cara de él y un tema con cara de Ryan. Esto ya está estructurado así.
But it seems at the moment that all the singles that come out, one side's yours, one side's Brian. Is it structured like that, or is it just the way it turns out?
That is a political ploy, actually, a diplomatic thing. Because obviously, I mean, I don't want to hog it all, but I mean, if you take a sort of average thing, most of the singles have been mine. I mean, the initial singles. But it does work out that if I have. It depends. If I have the first single, then somebody else has the second single. But it hasn't worked out on this. It's just like, well, I had Bicycle Race to start with, now I've got Don't Stop Me Now. We try and pick what we feel is the best song, really, no matter who's written it. But then it does so happen that who's written it does make a big thing. Sí. Es contradictory in terms, really.
Es un poco de contradicción esto, porque en teoría es la política de la banda tener un single de uno seguido con un single del otro y tener un cava de uno y la cava del otro. Pero en el último, los dos singles que han salido han sido suyos. Pero esto es la contradicción. Parece que gana todo el tiempo.
¿No cree que el título del EP de Jazz es un poco sorprendente o juega un poco a la contra? O sea, para mí no es un buen título del EP, o sea, desconcierta.
Pero no refleja lo que el EP...
O sea, desconcierta ese título. Entonces, ¿han jugado también al despropósito con esto?
Do you think the title for the album is a bit disconcerting?
Our titles always are. They're obviously totally remote from what the album is. It's just the way we feel the packaging and titles are. It's just a selling point. I think gone are the days where we want to have a title that's a sort of concept of the album. It's so boring. I think the packaging and a title should be for hard sell. And when you get the package inside, I mean, because our songs stand up on their own right. We feel that. They're so different anyway. To try and get a concept together, we just wouldn't. So what we do is try and come up with a title that has a good packaging sense and good marketing campaign. That's why we had Bicycle Race with all the naked girls and all that. That's all commercial. We've got to think in terms of those, you know. We're not...
Piensa mucho más en el lado comercial del LP. O sea, ninguno de sus LPs, el título, ha tenido mucho que ver con el contenido de la música de Enjoy. Pues después de todo, en su opinión, el concepto de un álbum que todo tiene una progresión consecutiva con el mismo rollo es aburrido. Así que miran la mejor forma de sacar algo para promocionarlo, para empaquetarlo y para ofrecerlo al público. Porque cada canción para él tiene su propio valor y para meterlo con un título genérico, igual poner uno como poner otro. Como las chicas, la carrera de bicicletas, todo ha sido el rollo de promoción y merchandising para hacer la carrera de bicicletas. El álbum ya nada más porque se grabó en Montreal.
Tell him this better be a long article.
Y dice que más vale que sea un artículo largo esto.
Mi última pregunta.
Last
mi última pregunta. ¿Alguna vez les ha visto la reina? ¿O les ha enviado una carta? O no sé, ¿han tenido algún contacto con la reina?
Last question. Have you ever had any contact with the Queen?
With the Queen herself? Oh my God, no.
Bitten,
that's my mother.
Benefit concert.
Su madre.
She's my mother. No. Not really, no.
Not really.
God, she's so remote. No way. I mean, the only thing we've had is that some of the fan letters from Yugoslavia one time went to the Buckingham Palace by mistake because it just said Queen, right? And she just, the lady in waiting probably just forwarded it back to her family.
No, lo único que ha pasado con esto es que algunos fans de Yugoslavia les escribieron poniendo Queen en el sobre y llegaban a la reina por equivocación y lo enviaban otra vez al club de fans de ellos.
No, mi última pregunta, last question for me. No, simplemente es, la despedida la hacen con el himno de Inglaterra, ¿no? De su álbum A Night at the Opera. O sea, si tiene algún significado patriótico esto, simplemente es porque queda bien para terminar.
Your version of God Save the Queen.
Yeah.
Is that patriotic?
Or? No, it's one way it is, but you see, it's also part of what we did on an album. It's not just something that's still album content, you know, it's part of our music. So we play it. It's like doing most of the songs we do are from the album, and that is like from Night of the Opera, just something to finish off with. That's our sort of way of ending it.
Más que ser patriótico es porque es algo que han hecho.
Okay.
Y es un final perfecto al concierto.
Okay. I only like to say thank you.
Thank you
for your answers.
That's when we go into the book.